Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 is only a few months away, at least seeing it for the first time, seeing what new features will be in it, as well as seeing iOS 15 Beta 1 released to developers, and then usually a few weeks later to public beta testers. And so I thought today they would probably announce when that event will be, since they do that generally around this time every year. Last year, they announced it on Friday, March 13th, 2020. They announced the Worldwide Developer Conference and said it would be in June, and that's where we saw iOS 14 for the first time, for example. However, today is about the same time frame, March 12th, it's a Friday in 2021, but so far we haven't seen that announcement. So I would expect that pretty soon, and that's where we'll see iOS 15 for the first time. So usually they announce it around this time, and last year they told us that it would be virtual. I would expect the same sort of thing this year. And so I wanted to talk about the overall leaks that we've seen so far, and also talk about what I'd like to see and what you'd like to see based off a Twitter poll or a Twitter comment I made the other day with hundreds of comments. So I wanted to talk about what to expect and then what you'd like to see that maybe we might see or may not see. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, though, please go ahead and give it a subscribe if you'd like to see more of these type of videos. And I post all the iOS update and iPhone sort of review and comparison videos as well quite regularly. And the first thing is the support for the overall iPhones. It's expected to have them drop support for the iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, and the first generation iPhone SE. These will lose support based on current information. Whether or not that's true is hard to say at this point. Hopefully there's still some hope out there for people, but they supported this for many years, and I've talked about that before at length. However, I do expect them to have some new features, and some people have been sort of leaking information, and hopefully some of it's right. I don't think that all of it will be correct, but there could be quite a few things. And the first thing is sizable widgets that could be in different sizes. Currently, we have different sizes for the widgets. You have a few different sizes. You've got a very large one for news, and you could see those sorts of widgets have different variables. Also interactive widgets, which seem to make a lot of sense. This year, I think Apple took their time to make sure the widgets work, which took a while to get them to work properly. They update based on when the developer sets it. But I think interactive widgets, whether that be for notes or weather or something like that, would be welcome. I know a lot of people would appreciate that. Also, an always-on display, and I thought I'd run through these quickly if you hadn't seen the other video, but an always-on display would be really nice, where it just gives you the time and maybe different notifications. And also, refresh notifications is said to be coming as well as some app refreshes as well. So some of these apps are starting to look a little bit dated. Some of the icons have been around a very long time, and we may see a redesign with that. And those redesigned icons may match Big Sur, where they have a little bit more depth to them. Some people don't like them, some people do, but it seems that we really should have some sort of refresh this year. And based off the Twitter post that I made, I went through all of these comments, and you'll see there's quite a few. So there's about 300 plus comments. I went through them all, and the main thing people wanted to see was a visual overhaul of the OS. This has been this design for quite some time, since iOS 7. It's sort of changed over time. We've gotten a redone App Store. We've had icons changed and things like music going back to older style icons. So we've seen some small visual changes as well as the control center, but we have not seen a large overhaul for years. And many people are saying we're not going to see that this year. Now that may change as we get closer to June and see the first version. I would really welcome a major overhaul, but I don't think we're going to see that anytime soon. So whether that be the interface, where there may be a new control center that's also in the more recent leaks, there may be a redoing of the control center with more organization and customization. I think we're going to see small visual changes this year, but I don't expect them to do a whole visual overhaul. Seeing them do that would take a lot of work and a rewrite of a lot of the code. It's possible they've been working on it for years, as they've been rewriting a lot of code for the latest Macs with the new Mac OS using Apple Silicon. But right now, I'd be very surprised if we saw a rewrite and a complete redesign, but maybe we will. The other thing most people were wanting was stability. iOS with 13 and now with iOS 14 have had some problems along the way, and we're really looking for stability. We've been wanting that for some time. I would say it's fairly stable at this point, but it's just not what most people remember with, say, iOS 12, for example, where it was pretty rock solid, dependable. We didn't have random freezing and crashes and different things crashing all over the place. So that's something I think we should see. and I'm sure they're working on that. I can't imagine Apple would want it to be unstable, so I would look forward to them doing that in the future and making sure that it's more stable as we move forward. The third most mentioned thing was people want better battery life. Battery life is pretty good, I think, on an iPhone 12 Pro Max or an iPhone 11 Pro Max, where you're going to get about 10 to 12 hours of screen on time. That's pretty good. It's some of the leading battery life in the industry, if not the very top, depending on what you're doing. So to see them make that stable and see that really maybe consistently get that with all the updates over years, I think would be a great thing. And I would love to see them make this a little bit better. There's a few people that said they would like to see customizable icons be a little bit easier to do. Instead of having to use shortcuts, you would be able to customize icons, for example. So being able to customize icons and even turn off the app library, some people said, but then you saw competing comments where people said they wanted the app library on the iPad. So it really depends on if you like it and use it or not. Also, proper scaling for different phones. Now, what that means is the different icon sizes between, say, an iPhone 12 mini versus an iPhone 12 Pro Max and any in between. Sometimes they just don't scale properly between different devices. I think Apple does a pretty good job of this, but when you go to things like iPad and you go through all these different sizes, sometimes there's just some strange inconsistencies and scaling issues between that. So you'd like to see that as well. Also, many people would like to see a better settings page. Now, this is rumored to change with the upcoming releases. And I think one thing they could change dramatically is let's put some of these settings accessible in the app itself. So for example, I know there's consistency on macOS where you click the top bar, for example, but the camera settings, they started to bring some of those across, such as record video, 4K 60. But when you go into the camera app, we don't have access to turn on HDR video or turn it off here or any of those other settings. I would like to see the options that we have in the settings app brought over here, maybe with a quick menu to the side. It seems to make a lot of sense to have a consistent menu throughout that's not needing us to go back to a settings page, go back in, adjust all this, then go back to camera and back and forth until we get it right. I think that would be a huge improvement if we saw something like that. Another thing that a lot of people want is split view multitasking, like you can do on an iPad, for example. A lot of people want this on an iPhone, including myself. I think it'd be very helpful if you were watching YouTube, for example, or maybe you were in a call and you could get to your notes more easily, for example, without having a picture in picture, but rather maybe we go to settings and then we want to bring in the App Store, for example, and we bring that over to the side. We can use it just like this, or we could bring in, say, music here. So if we go to music, maybe we'll bring that in and now they overlap this way. Or if we go home, we could go into music, for example, then bring in, say, the App Store. Something like this would be very welcome on an iPhone with maybe YouTube here and your text messaging here. We've seen that on Android, but I'd like to see Apple implement it with all their privacy and security as well. It's something I think a lot of people would like. A lot of people have been asking for things we should be seeing in iOS 15, such as dynamic widgets and notification changes. And there's a couple things I thought were more notable that would be interesting if we saw, but are less likely. For example, complications for the iPhone like we have on the watch. So on the watch, we have different complications where we can put maybe the weather for today, a compass, your activity, or any of these other things. It'd be nice to have those here where we could set those on the lock screen, for example. Also, quite a few people wanted call recording. Now, this is something we haven't seen due to a lot of legal issues throughout the world. Based on where you live, there's different laws. So I don't think we're going to see that anytime soon, but I know a lot of people would appreciate that, but I don't really expect that. Another thing I thought was really interesting that I would like to see is walkie-talkies. We have this on the Apple Watch, and there used to be phones in the United States called Nextel phones where you could pick a contact, hit a button, and it was like a walkie-talkie between anyone around the world. I would love to see that not just on the watch now, because we do have it on the watch, but I would love to see that, for example, on the phone, where you have walkie-talkie here with maybe some close friends and family. That would be something really nice. Also, someone mentioned a couple security things I thought would be interesting. Someone suggested maybe unlocking your phone with voice recognition. That would be pretty interesting instead of just trying to kind of get the weather or some important information and it asking you for a passcode. You could just unlock it by recognizing your voice. Google has some things like this. The chipset inside the iPhones are very capable of doing this. And so that seems to be something they could do, but they'd have to be very careful about that. Also, when people grab your phone, for example, and want to shut it down, they can do that right now without entering a passcode. I've heard this many, many times as a security reason. Let's have a passcode to shut the phone down. That makes a lot of sense to me, and I think that should be a feature they should add, or at least have you have the option to add in case someone takes your phone, they can shut it down. Then you can no longer track your phone. I think it would be great to not allow you to turn it off. And then the final thing I thought was interesting that we thought we would see with iOS 14 at some point is editable iMessage. So meaning you could edit your text messages, delete them individually, and have expiring messages as well. Similar to say Snapchat, even Telegram allows that, but having that within messages would be great and add another level of security. Something else I would like to see is have this brought across to Android. I think they could use a new app, not just Telegram, for example, but a new app to replace WhatsApp, since WhatsApp is sort of something a lot of people are seemingly getting away from. So I think all of those things make a lot of sense. I would love to see them change. So far, there's only a few of them. And then on the iPad, people had a few suggestions as well, or things they wanted to see. One of those, for example, was bringing the app library. There's no app library. People want to see that on iPad as well, or at least have the option to use it, as well as widgets that don't just stick to the left, but they can move around. I think I hear that not just on iPad, but on iPhone, and being able to move your icons wherever you want instead of them having you stick them left to right, top to bottom. I think a lot of people would really appreciate that, and I would love to see that myself. So I'm really looking forward to iOS 15 and iPadOS 15, as well as watchOS 8 and macOS 11.5 or macOS 12, whatever they decide to call it this year. I'm really looking forward to all of those things, and hopefully they'll have at least a handful of what I've already mentioned in this particular update. But let me know what feature you would want to see most in the comments below. There's a bunch that we could see. What would you want as your number one feature? If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.